Hi, my name's Paul Grunier and I'm a volunteer with Martin Fleischmann Memorial Project. So over the lunch break, we have done a map of the area, and I wanted to do this to find the area where the first of these structures were found, and it is in this area here, and it is this one here. It's a little bit blown out, but in this view, we can see some of it is coming out of the carbonite, as I call it, and some of it's going below, and so we can find that. You can also see many of these crenellated iron spheres here. Yeah, there's probably one that sat there before it launched itself somewhere. But we can have a look at this area very rapidly. So I hope to share this data with you all. Okay. There probably was one here. And in this image also, there are the split ones, which are up and to the left, which I hope are still there. So where is that? Up and to the left, that's somewhere here, I guess. Yes, so the first one is over here. Yes, so it's still there, fantastic. Look, there is our section of our torus that's blown up, and it's left this carbon deposit with this mark here, and then over here we should have another one a little bit further over here, maybe. I don't think this is the best example, actually. Visual reference here. So, there. A little bit angle from that. It's about there. Let's see it. Let's see it. Let's get that one first. That one is there. That one's there, that's the one we must see. And then basically straight across from there, somewhere over here. No. Okay, so I think we'll look at the split one and the whole one that we can do today. Any other things of interest in the ball length, which is out of focus? Lovely crenellated sphere here. Another one there on its own. Oh, there's a ring there. Oh, that looks like a nice one. Oh, and we've got a ring and a split ring. Yes, and another split part of ring there. Okay, we like that. That is over in this area, which is a little bit over to the left. Okay, all right, so we definitely want to go there. Oh, we've got a hole ring there. Whole ring, split ring, split ring. Beautiful. Oh, yes. Awesome. Okay, all right. Joy, oh joy. Let's see if we can find those then. Whole ring, split ring, split ring. In fact, now what I'm going to do, maybe I can find it. Oh, I'll get on that there. This one down. That'll be whole ring, split ring, split ring. Maybe that let that go. Make it go. Oh no. Oh no. There we go. Whole ring, split ring, split ring. So we are looking for this block here, this channel here. Okay, that's in the center. Okay. Can you see where it is? Yeah. The thing on an SEM, you can think you're in a small area, but it's actually a massive area. Okay. So what am I looking at? It's called this feature and that feature. This area. I don't want to stray too far from this area, so I'm going to put a memory spot. Memory spot. And we'll travel over a little bit out here. See if we can see anything we recognize. Not really. No, don't think I have any others. I'm so easy to find this guy. Where did I do it? Am I down here or up here? Is there a way to click on this and it takes you to that area in the sample? Michal?
Sorry?
Is there a way you can click on something and it takes you to that area in the sample on using this?
So.
Oh, that's a real shame. So I'd like to go there. Export current view. That would be nice. I'd like to, because I've got a ring here and I've got a fragment and a fragment of a ring.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so, well, probably have to.
Export current view. I can do this.
Yeah, if you want to have just this image, then you can export this one.
And as a tip as well, maybe it'll be 16-bit.
Should be. That's probably.
That would be nice. Oh dear. I love this one. At the head of this, you've got a field structure.
Mm-hmm.
So that's nice as well. Anyway, that's the where I want to go to first. So.
Yeah. We will have to
find it.
Certain
find something that makes sense. Like this area, if I'm here, I'm going up that way. Let's see what I've got. It's like trying to find a barn in Wyoming. Oh, no, hold on. This looks good. Is that anywhere we need to be? Ooh, hello. Hello. Alright, where do we want to be? Over there? Is it that way? I don't know.
It was below.
Was it?
This one?
Is it?
No. Oh, slightly different one.
Yeah, it's like that, isn't it? There. No, it's here. Yeah, this section. Yeah, it's this section.
Mm-hmm.
So, I am.
As much as possible. Still somewhere here.
Am I there? So.
It's here.
Let me have a look.
So I'm zoom.
That is as unzoomed as I can go.
Okay.
So it's up this way.
So you can even go to 5 kilovolts then. And then you can go to magnification like 250, maybe 300, something like that.
Okay, well, I think that's good to know, but I think I found it now, or I'm close to finding it. I think it's somewhere around here. We got a ball there with a bit there. Where was it? Here. Yep. There. Ball there, bit there. Good. Excellent. So here is our toroid and breakup or toroid parts. Oh, hello, my friends. Hello, my friend, hello. I just called to say hello. What a piece of magic. Look at that. Two, three, four, five, six. That's 6 segments around there, and then however many segments are here. What a thing of beauty.
Oh my. Oh my God, look at that.
So this one is, yeah, didn't want to go in that close. This one is a structure 5 microns. 5 microns. Roughly 5 microns. One point 25 microns. it's just, this is the debris field of breakups. You've got this tube which is spiraling. There's a fragment here, fragments in here. There's actually, looks like toroids here, and the iron sphere here. We've got the crenellated sphere here. This is just fantastic. So this really captures it all. Whole torus, fragments, buried fragments, more fragments, torrids. Thing of great beauty. There's even little segments over here. One fragment here. Wow. How long have I got?
Sorry?
How long have I got?
From the time?
How long have I got? Yeah.
How
much time do I have?
Yeah. Half an hour.
Yikes.
How long?
How
long?
Yeah.
Okay, so.
So, this sculpture here. Microns. And it's definitely hexagonal. Torus. And it is wider on the outside. It's got 3/8 to the inside. Wow. So I think that these are either, I think these will be carbon and oxygen and calcium. I think we'll come out to the wider angle so that we've got a bunch of stuff in here. Let's go and have a quick look at this. So again, there's some segments over here. And you can see the toroidal section here. It's over going to refresh. There you go, toroid end on. That is a thing of beauty right there. Maybe I can get some SCD to give me some impression of the depth here. So we expect this to have iron in it. Expect that to have iron in it. Iron and oxygen. Atomic concentration. Fe a little bit more though. And then this one. Bigger circle, it might be. Second one is got some calcium in it. Bigger, bigger. This one might have calcium in it. And we'll look at the edge on this tide. And then we'll have a look at the substrate. And then we'll have a look at this carbonaceous blob in the filament here. So we are on the second spot. What's the second spot? S. Carbon and oxygen. First spot was more iron, carbon and oxygen. Third spot is, as we predicted, calcium.
Yes, I love it when the plan comes together.
So we are currently looking at this part of the toroid. Yes, carbon, oxygen, calcium. Some sodium. And this one is on the same kind of stuff, carbon, oxygen, calcium. So if you wanted to know where your calcium comes from in LENR, there we go. And this looks like a big fraction of a torus, and this one does, so I'm going to have a quick look at that as well. That one is definitely nearly 24% calcium by weight and almost entirely calcium carbon oxygen. This one is interesting. Where are we on that one? That's that one. It's over here. That is the substrate, which is, of course, got sodium, which may have been synthesized. And yes. It's bosonic, so it gets kicked out. Copper and zinc, and then we are looking at the central carbon area, probably here. Atomic concentration, 92.92%. There we go. Takaki Matsumoto, you're brown, you're correct. And sulfur coming in there, of course. Basically carbon, oxygen, sodium. Yeah, so atomic concentration, 90% carbon, 5.3% oxygen, sodium, some trace zinc and copper, and a bit of sulfur. What are we looking at? This is part of the arm here, and again, it's mostly carbon. Carbon and oxygen. Last one here, which may be a big one, carbon, oxygen, sodium, okay, and nitrogen. Okay, so this is obviously a bigger structure, less coherence maybe. That's how that resulted in that. Okay, so I'm going to come out of there, and we're going to see if we can do our original one and the split one, which is in this area, and that's where I am relative to this. Yeah, here, and we need to go where? To the triangle area, so it's down, down and up, down and right. There we go, that's a very big triangle section. We're looking for something that's a bit above there. Not about so much there. Okay, so it's there. This is our original one that was found by chance. There you are, you little beauty. Chanta Baba. Oh, look at it. What a thing of extremity. You can see almost the field structure around it. And this is coming out, so if we actually go to SED, you can see a little bit more like overall structure. This is coming out, so I think it blew off this side. So you can see the inside of Taurus here. And just the brightness on there. That's a little bit what a thing of beauty. It's like a red blood cell but in divisions. There we go, so this one. Mm-hmm. And I suspect this is calcium. You will soon know. Mm-hmm. Interestingly, there is another structure here which almost looks like it's part of a sphere, which it may be. And we'll have a look at that as well. So, what have we got? We've got a bit of SED to give us some shape form. Yeah, definitely some sort of structure here. Okay, we'll see if that's calcium then, or iron, that's probably part of the same story.
Yeah, it didn't matter, it didn't work.
So, what do we have? On the end of this one, in the split part of the torus. Well, there we go. Calcium, oxygen, carbon, almost exclusively. What is this one here? And there seems to be some kind of structure here. Yeah, look at that. Nearly a third by weight. It's almost like CO2. CO, calcium. Yeah. Yeah, this is another structure. And we'll have a look at that one. And we'll have a look at Sodium rich. In this area here, almost all carbon. A little bit of chlorine, sulfur. Potassium. Elements for life. One more bean to get, and then I'll see if I can drop that sample in and just have a quick look. Mm-hmm. I couldn't have wished for more. Oh, look at this.
This is the torus.
And you can see the calcium in it. And there's another section here. So this was the first one I found. It's just
freaking magic.
It's just magic. There's the toy. Somewhere here and here. Maybe it's my bottom structure. Maybe here and here. Mm-hmm. Almost looks like there's a water structure here, there and there. Look, vortex, vortex. Yeah, these two are definitely in the same family of exotic vacuum object collapse wave functions. Yeah. Oxygen, calcium. Calcium and oxygen. Measurements here. The distance between two sections is 800. Between that, somewhere over there, 5.85, centered, it's in the... So this is actually, you can see here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 6. This is like 4 differently. On the outside here, no, I didn't want to do that. Here I've got 789 nanometers, and then here 409. I think this will line up proportionally with what I saw in the Hutchinson sample. Let's dial up this acting medium so I can see what I'm doing quick. I'm out of here, pull that one sample. Ah, there he is. Come to Papa. Heavily broken sample. Yes, calcium carbon oxygen. Very, very predictable now. Carbon and oxygen and zinc and copper with the sodium. And what is in the center of this area here? Where this looks like it blew up. We'll find out. It is carbon, oxygen. Even more here. Oxygen. Oxygen is carbon and oxygen, basically. So thank you very much for your time, and I'll see you in the next video.